The facts of the matter is that yesterday both Comrade Raja and I wrote separate letters to the governor of J&K, telling the governor that we are going to visit today, meet our comrades, and I had mentioned that Comrade Yusuf Tarigami is not keeping good health. He is in need of some medicines, so it is necessary for me to meet him. And on that basis, we left for Srinagar this morning. At the airport, we were met by a posse of policemen who very promptly and very efficiently took our bags away and they led us into a room there. Then they said that our orders are to send you back in the same flight in which we came. We said, nothing doing, we are not going. We have come here with return tickets. Our return flight, whenever it goes, we'll go by that flight. And in the meanwhile, we want to go into the city and meet our comrades and come back. But that they didn't allow. Then I said, are we under detention? Or where is the order of detaining us? Then a magistrate was summoned, a lady magistrate, who came with the orders where it is mentioned that specifically by my name, saying that not allowed to proceed into the city. Even if I were to proceed into the city escorted by the police, untoward incidents can occur, and therefore, for the question of law and order, it should not be done. They had information that Raja is coming yesterday itself, so they were wondering what had happened. But the fact of the matter was, it is a judicial and a police custody. So we stayed in protest. We stayed there for 4 hours. And when our return flight time was there, then we returned in that flight. This is what has happened. Now, what we have done was, through a proper information given to the authorities concerned, the reason for going there is also something you cannot deny. The general secretaries of two national parties to meet their own comrades in the state of Jammu and Kashmir in Srinagar. And particularly when I mentioned, Yusuf Tarigami is a four-time MLA. An MLA is 6 years in J&K. So for 24 years, he's been elected as an MLA repeatedly. He's a very tall, known figure. But they refused to let him go. So finally, we could ascertain that he is under house arrest. And they assured that they will send the necessary medicines, etc., etc. So then I wrote a letter, and I insisted the letter be delivered to him, which the SP, the police in charge of that district, and he assured that it will be delivered. But let us see. I mean, everything is under censorship. So the point is this: this is our democratic right to meet our own comrades, all citizens of India. In a purely open activity. It was done with full information and full knowledge of everyone. But yet not being allowed to go in, that really shows that there's something that is not being, the truth is not out with all of us. Why is it that, if there's everything is all okay according to what the central government is claiming, if all is well in Kashmir, then why were we stopped? And why were we not allowed to meet our people when it was openly declared activity? That is the serious violation of our democratic rights. And all that we are saying is that let us allow us to meet our own comrades and our own leaders. But that was not permitted. So that is what happened today. And from this, we'll all have to draw the necessary conclusions of what is happening. From all the talks we could have with people, random people, and with the officials in the airport, things are under complete control of the central forces. I don't know the state forces and the state authorities, what role they have there now, but it's completely under the central control. And that is what it's likely to stay. That is what it appears from what they say. But the fact is that why none of them were even taken into confidence before all this happened was something that was a constant question amongst those people who were there, who flew with us, who were asking us in the flights, and also in the airport there. So this in a nutshell is what happened. So 4 days, 4 hours under their custody, in protest, we both stayed and refused to come back by the same returning flight. And then we came back on our original schedule.
Friends, as Comrade Sitaram explained, we went there properly informing the governor. We wrote separate letters. We told the governor in our letters, we as general secretaries, separate letters. I wrote as general secretary of CPI, I am going there to meet my party leaders, my party members. The administration should allow me to reach out to my party people. But as soon as we landed there, some security people came, promptly took our bags and led us to a room. We were kept in a room. We were not even allowed to move around the airport lawns or interact with ordinary common people. We were asked to sit in the room, remain in the room. That's what happened. And what I understand from my observations, the situation is not normal at all. It is very tense. There is fear, and the situation is very scary. Even the employees, they admit the government, the way it did the scrapping of Article 370, should not have been done in such a way. People were not taken into confidence. The political parties were not taken into confidence. What is going to be the future? We do not know. So I think there is a great amount of anxiety, uncertainty in the minds of the people about the future. Whatever the Prime Minister spoke addressing the nation, people have their own doubts why the state was downgraded. This was during our travel in plane or talking to some employees, we could gather. And this is what government should understand. And we have not gone there as underground activists. We went there as leaders of political parties and general secretaries of our respective parties. And how come they didn't allow us to go out and meet our own comrades? That way, even Mr. Ghulam Nabi Azad, they were saying Ghulam Nabi Azad was kept here only, sir. They were telling. And he is the former chief minister of Jammu and Kashmir. He is from that state. How come he was not allowed to go out? I can't understand. And in our case also, we informed the governor. And why we were not allowed? Rather, we were detained, confined to one room. And they asked us to sit, remain in that room, not to move here and there. Even to go to office, they didn't allow. So this is what is going on in Jammu and Kashmir. And the whole country should understand the deteriorating situation in Jammu and Kashmir. The whole nation should rise in support of the people of Jammu and Kashmir. It is not for people of Jammu and Kashmir. It is for the people of the entire country. We should stand up and we should speak for the constitutional morality, the constitution and democracy. And the left parties will continue to protest, continue to raise our voice, and we will not be succumbed by BJP and its government. Somebody asked me, the opposition leaders are going and creating problems. Why you should go to Jammu and Kashmir? I told them, Jammu and Kashmir is part of our nation, and India doesn't belong to BJP. India belongs to all of us, and we have every right to go any part of the country and meet people. And BJP should understand it should conduct itself as a responsible political party, not questioning the propriety of other political parties, the morality of other political parties. This is what we thought we should tell you at this point of time. You